Dear students, today I am going to deal with English grammar, active and passive voice, part 4. Already we have seen changing from active to passive. Today we shall see how to change from passive voice to active voice. It is same like active voice to passive voice exercise. Only thing, we have to do the steps in reverse order. You should learn the following examples. Now, particularly the object after by will change into subject, and you should give importance to verb change. Now you can see the tabular column. Change of verbs from passive to active voice. See, in the simple present tense, in the passive voice it will be am or is or are plus past participle or verb 3. That is for singular, are for plural, written. Written is third form of the verb. In active voice, it will change into verb 1, that is write or writes. Here verb 1 and verb 1 plus yes, write or writes. Okay. Now coming to second one, simple past you see. Was, were. Singular means was, plural means were, plus verb 3. And in the active voice you see, past tense means it will be verb 2. Okay, so simple past you see, was or were, written. In the past tense, active voice, it will be wrote. Now coming to simple future, shall or will be plus verb 3. It can also coincide for can be, could be, should be, would be, may be, might be, must be, plus verb 3. Okay. And will be written. So verb 3 is write, wrote, written. Verb 3 is written. Now coming to active voice, you see, we can use shall or will plus verb 1. Can, could, should, would, may, might, must. Always these models in the present tense will be followed by verb 1 only. So will write. Okay. Now coming to fourth one, present continuous. So we are using am, is, are plus being plus verb 3. So already we have seen. So in the continuous, how it is used? Is or are being written. How will it change into active voice? Am, is, are will be same, plus verb plus ing, that is base verb only. Okay, that is verb 1. That means is or are writing. Coming to fifth one, you see past continuous. It is was for singular, were for plural, plus being plus verb 3. So was or were being written. In active voice it is was or were plus verb plus ing. So was or were writing. Now coming to the next one, sixth one, you see present perfect. So present perfect means have, has. For plural, I, we, you, they, we use have. For he, she, it, we use has plus been plus verb 3. So has or have been written. And in the active voice you see have or has plus verb 3. Have or has written. Always have, has will be followed by verb 3. Now coming to the seventh one, past perfect. So had plus been, because for singular or plural we use had. Had plus been plus verb 3. So had been written. When it changes into active voice, had plus verb 3. Had written. Now coming to the last one, that is future perfect. Will or shall plus have plus been plus verb 3. That means will have been written or shall have been written. In the active voice, will or shall plus have plus V3, that is past participle. Then will have written. So you should note the things that present perfect continuous do not have any passive voice. Okay, in the same way, past perfect continuous also doesn't have passive voice. Then future continuous and future perfect continuous too do not have passive voice. Dear students, we shall see how the changes occur in simple present tense. The whistle is blown by him. The object is the whistle. Okay, it has become the subject in the passive voice. Now we are changing it to active voice. Step 1, him changes into he. Step 2, is blown, is or are plus verb 3. It is present tense is blow. Okay, step 3, object is the whistle. And you see step 4, the final, he blows the whistle. For he or she or it, the verb takes an yes, you know. For he, she, it, you have to add yes to the verb. Then only it becomes present tense. Now coming to simple past tense. The whistle was blown by him. Step 1, you see, him changes into he. And you see, step 2, was blown will become was or were plus past participle, that is verb 3. That is, past tense is blew, B-L-E-W, blew. So step 3, the object is the whistle. Step 4, completion, you see, he blew the whistle. Coming to simple future tense, the whistle will be blown by him. So we see verb 1 is blow, verb 2 is blew, verb 3 is blown. So step 1, him changes into he. Step 2, you see, will be blown, will be plus verb 3, that is past participle. Future tense, that is will blow. And you see step 3, object is the whistle. Step 4, on completion, he will blow the whistle. Just we shall see the comprehensive table, passive to active voice, all tenses, and we are only dealing with statements. Okay, passive voice, you see, the whistle is blown by him. So an active voice, he blows the whistle. What is the tense? Simple present. Then second one, you see, the whistle was blown by him. So active voice, he blew the whistle. So what tense is it? Simple past. The whistle will be blown by him. In the passive voice, in the active voice, you see, he will blow the whistle. And you see the tense, simple future. Now the whistle is being blown by him in the passive voice. Now changing into active voice, he is blowing the whistle. What tense? Present continuous. Now the whistle was being blown by him occurs in passive voice. Changing into active voice, he was blowing the whistle. And tense is past continuous. Next, in the passive voice, you see the whistle has been blown by him. So active voice, he has blown the whistle. Been will be cut. Then you see the tense, present perfect. Now coming to the next, the whistle had been blown by him. In the passive voice, you see this. Now coming to active voice, he had blown the whistle. This is past perfect tense. Now coming to the last, you see, the whistle will have been blown by him. So in the passive voice, it is like this. Now changing into active voice, he will have blown the whistle. So the tense is future perfect. We shall move on to passive to active voice, interrogative, that means questions. You see the first one, the passive voice, by whom was grammar taught? So active voice, very easy. Who taught you grammar? Second one, when was the book bought by you? Was is past tense in passive voice. So here, active voice, when did you buy the book? Now third one, you see, were the holidays spent by you usefully? In the active voice, did you spend the holidays usefully? Next one, has the problem been solved by you? In passive voice, you see, now changing into active voice, have you solved the problem? Now coming to the last one, which book is wanted by you? In passive voice, changing into active voice, which book do you want? Next, you see, passive to active voice, sentences without doer. If the doer is not given in the passive voice, Use the word someone or somebody or add any subject related to the sentence. Doctor or manager or principal or captain, etc. in the active voice. Okay. See the example. The building had been demolished. So, the doer of the action is absent. So, you have to use in the active voice. Answer, you see, someone had demolished the building. Second one, books were published in 2019. So, answer is the managing director published the books in 2019. Okay. Dear students, hope you have understood all the concepts. Please go through the video so that you will understand better. Okay, with this I wind up the class and I shall continue in the next class. Thank you.